The federal government is promising a new default energy price will save some households more than $800 a year on their power bills. In a move that once again regulates prices, Energy Minister Angus Taylor says new laws will ensure people aren't disadvantaged by being loyal to one provider and for not shopping around. Here's Alan Kohler on that and the other day's news in finance.
The government announced three things on electricity today. First, a new price safety net, or cap. Second, an intention to support investment in new generation. And third, forcing companies to sign contracts to guarantee supply, otherwise known as hedges. There used to be electricity price caps, but in 2003, the PERA review, as it was called, which included the current chairman of the ACCC, by the way, Rod Sims, recommended that they be removed. In 2007, that was supported by the then regulator, the Australian Energy Market Commission, which said price regulation was unnecessary. So it duly happened around Australia. And that went well, didn't it? Prices have since gone up by 55%, thanks partly to expanding retail margins, taking them to the highest in the world, as shown by this chart from the ACCC's July report, which accused the retailers of deliberately confusing customers and price gouging. So today, the Energy Minister, Angus Taylor, wrote to the Australian Energy Regulator ordering it to start work on a regulated price safety net by 2019. So, back to the future. The support for new generation looks like being modelled on Victoria's scheme of underwriting renewable generation with a price guarantee set by reverse auction. Now, the first of these was announced last month and it led to six projects totalling $1.4 billion, three wind and three solar. But of course, the federal government scheme will be technology neutral, as they say, and won't specify solar and wind. And finally, forced hedging. Here's the ACCC's chart of current hedging by the retailers. And they're well covered already, so no change needed. Unsurprisingly, energy companies AGL and Origin led the retreat on the local share market today, what with the threat of tough new price regulation. Resources and banks also fell pretty heavily, and Healthscope jumped after getting one of those maybe takeover bids. And the Aussie dollar has gone below 71 US cents for the first time in a week or two. And that's finance.